When you see their flags, start swimming. I'm Ashley with WatchMojo, and these are the top 10 strongest One Piece pirate crews. For this list, we're looking at the pirate crews across this monumental franchise, ranking them on their combined strength and infamy across all four oceans. Keep in mind, we won't be including militarized organizations like the Revolutionary Army, nor crews seen exclusively in movies like the Gold Lion Pirates. We also won't be including the Rock Pirates, since while their crew did consist of younger versions of iconic characters like Whitebeard, Big Mom, and Kaido, we want to focus more on their individual careers as terrors of the high seas. As always, you can catch me on Twitter at AshJBow, so head over there, give me a follow, and let me know which One Piece pirate crew you think is the strongest. If you like what you're hearing, be sure to check out the full song at the link below. Number 10, Fire Tank Pirates.
What? This is crazy! Something is flying out of his chest!
Pirates and Mafia may seem like they're on opposite ends of the criminal spectrum, but as Capone Beg and his gang proved, they can fall together rather seamlessly, especially if you have a devil fruit that turns your body into a fortress, complete with a whole slew of cannons.
I don't know how that power works, but I think I'm starting to see why they call him the gang!
With a Don persona that's not just for show, Beg's familia are some real tough customers. They can certainly hold themselves in a gunfight, and while they originally had the backing of Big Mom, they just couldn't resist trying to take her out to climb the pirate ladder.
Mama no koto wa kanarazu papa ga tatsukete agemachu kara ne.
Number 9, Heart Pirates.
Captain!
Fitting name, really, on account that Trafalgar Law has melted many hearts in his time and removed a few from his enemies. The Surgeon of Death may not be the most bombastic pirate to stem from the worst generation, but he sure as hell is one of the deadliest, having one of the most sought-after devil fruits of the modern era. Allowing him to take his enemies apart and reattach them instantly, as well as grant eternal youth at the cost of his own life. We also can't forget he's got a yellow submarine full of rapscallions who know how to bring the pain, especially his kung fu polar bear pal, Beppo. Number 8, Donquixote Family. With friends like these, taking over a kingdom is child's play. By himself, Doflamingo stands as one of the strongest among the seven warlords of the sea, capable of ripping his foes apart with his threads or turning them into his puppets. Acting out his depraved will are his elite officers, one of whom can literally become a moving mountain. Even the regular officers under them can't be considered weak, since the likes of Lao Ji and Gladius wrecked numerous combatants by themselves, while Sugar's ability to turn her foes into dolls and erase their public existence was the stuff of nightmares. Number 7, Straw Hat Pirates. It says a lot when even the main characters are low down on this list. Though we have no doubt with time and training, Luffy and his companions will soon catch up. As it stands now, this motley crew are nothing to scoff at. Even the so-called weaker members like Usopp, Chopper, and Nami have managed to excel in recent years. Combine that with Sanji's mad kicking skills, the ungodly badassery of soon-to-be Master Swordsman Zoro, plus the recent addition of Jinbei, well, almost, and you're looking at a bad time if you pick a fight. That's all before you consider the monumental power of the Straw Hat Fleet. As for Luffy himself, every time he gets knocked down, he just snaps back up with even greater force. Number 6, Blackbeard Pirates. In the beginning, Marshal D. Teach was nothing more than a murderer with a couple of loyal allies and an insanely powerful devil fruit at his disposal. A killer pain in the backside, but not exactly a threat that could turn the world on its head. And then he hopped into Impel Down, freed the most dangerous criminals they had, and made them his crew. It's still amazing that a giant as large as a navy base, the most infamous female pirate ever imprisoned, a disgraced navy jailer with a passion for murder, and a slew of other nutjobs all banded together under one guy. Then again, he does have two devil fruit powers. Over the time skip, they've only gotten more powerful, taking down the remnants of the Whitebeard crew and even stealing the abilities of whomever they choose. Number 5, Big Mom Pirates. Make all the jokes you want about this sadistic old bat having over 40 kids, the truth of the matter is, the majority of them are so proficient with haki that they're leagues above your average pirate. Acting as the enforcers for her vast empire, running into any one of Lin Lin Charlotte's offspring is practically a death sentence. Especially if it's one of the three sweet commanders, even more so if his name is Katakuri. Of course, Mama ain't no slouch either, since her size and strength allow her to rip through anyone who disturbs her tea parties. And if she's feeling particularly nasty, she'll rip out your soul. Number 4, Red Hair Pirates. They're always up for a drink and a good time, they're all fundamentally decent people, and if you try to hurt someone they care about, they'll send you to a watery grave before you can even blink. Even missing an arm, Shanks' strength is something else, able to go toe-to-toe with Whitebeard and basically ended a war just by showing up. The caliber of his crew is also astronomical, with Usopp's father, Yasopp, making every sniper out there crap themselves thanks to his marksmanship skills, while Ben Beckman made frickin' Kizaru nervous just by holding him at gunpoint. Here's hoping we get to see them rampage in the near future.
Luffy.
Number 3, Beast Pirates. Not even sure why a man like Kaido even needs a crew, on account that the bloke is nigh unkillable. The fact he can shrug off multiple executions and suicide attempts with little to no damage would make anyone trepidatious. But then you've got his raw power that's capable of knocking out Luffy like he's pre-time skip Kobe. Topping it all off is his mythical zone devil fruit that can turn him into one beastly looking dragon. The fact he's got such vast underworld connections, all of Wano in his back pocket, as well as subordinates as deadly as King, Queen, and Jack, is all honestly just the icing on the cake by this point. You can see why Orochi came to power with this crew in his corner. Number 2, Whitebeard Pirates. While it's true that the power and influence of these legends has vastly diminished following the tragic deaths of Whitebeard and Ace, we're choosing to look at these guys when they were in their prime. Even well into his twilight years, Pops was a titan of the sea. The only thing more impressive than the tremors he could cause with his fists being the respect and love he garnered from his crewmates. Explains why he was able to gather such immensely talented sons like Marco the Phoenix, Diamond Josu, Oz Jr., and the one and only Firefist Ace. The world will never know another crew like them. Before we continue, be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. You have the option to be notified for occasional videos or all of them. If you're on your phone, make sure to go into your settings and switch on notifications. Number 1, Roger Pirates. There's OG Pirates, and then there's Gold D. Roger. The Pirate King who kickstarted a whole new era, the original owner of the Straw Hat, the man who hears the voices of all things, and arguably had the greatest mustache the world has ever seen. While his deeds and legacy forged the very foundation of One Piece, we can't forget about his crew. Shanks and Buggy found their start in life on board the decks of the Oro Jackson, and we all know how they turned out. Not to mention Roger's partner in crime, legendary right-hand man, and Luffy's future mentor, the Dark King Rayleigh. They were likely at their strongest when Odin was in their ranks, able to claim the prize that no other pirate has managed thus far, finding Joy Boy's treasure. They're on a level yet to be surpassed. So which of these crews do you think is the strongest? Let us know in the comments below, maybe follow this guy on Twitter at AshJBow, check out this other video, and subscribe to WatchMojo. So do you agree with our picks? Let us know in the comments. And hey, if you're a fan of the song playing right now, be sure to check out the music video for it right here.